In this tutorial, we will create three sketches, this, this, and this one. In this series of tutorials, we are learning Fusion 360 from start to finish. In the previous tutorial, we have learned about user interface and sketch basics. Now, we are solving these exercises based on that tutorial. So, link to that tutorial is given in description. I request you to watch this complete tutorial to understand Fusion 360 sketching concept perfectly. To receive new video notification every alternate Monday and Wednesday, please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this first exercise. Now, this sketch we will start creating from this point. So at first we will create this line of 100, then 50, then 80, again 50, and 150. Click here on create sketch, click on top plane, pan it on this side, then click here, so unit of mm is correct. Click here on line, click on this origin point, take your cursor on this side, ensure that your line is straight, specify length of 100, click. Then take your cursor on this side, ensure that angle is 90 degree, length is 50, click. Then take your cursor on this side, 80, click. Then take it below, click, then zoom minus, pan it, take your cursor on this side, 150, click, right click, cancel. So here base lines are ready. So while creating these lines, we have specified dimensions when creating lines. In next portion, what we will do, at first we will create this portion and we will place these dimensions later on. So type L for line, click here on this endpoint, take your cursor on this side, click, then on this side click, pan it below, click, click, take it below, take it on this side, click, on this side, click, zoom minus, then take your cursor to this endpoint so it will track it, click and click, then right click, cancel. Then we will specify this 100, this 150, then this total height of 250. Click here on sketch dimension, click on this line, take your cursor on this side, click, 100, enter, then click on this line, take it below, click, 150, enter, then click on this line, click, 250, enter, then this height is 50, click, 50, enter, then right click, cancel. Then these lines needs to be collinear. So for that, click here on collinear, click on this line. Then these lines are also collinear, click on this line. Then these two lines, click, click. Then these two lines will also be collinear. So click and click. So here this sketch is fully defined. Right click, cancel. So all the parameters are defined. You can rearrange these dimensions as per your need. Then next is to create this circle of 40 radius, that is 80 diameter, and this one of 60 diameter. So click on center diameter circle, click, take it away, 80, enter, then right click, repeat center diameter circle, click, take it away 60, enter. Then specify dimensions, click here on sketch dimension, click on this line, click on this center point, take it outside, click 75, enter. Again this center point, this line, click 75, enter. So this circle is fully defined. Then here 80 and 115. Click, 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 115, enter. And click, 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 80, enter. Then fit. So this sketch is perfectly ready. Right click, cancel. Then click here on new design. Then next is this one. Now in this sketch, at first we will create this horizontal line of 75 length and this inclined line at angle of 45 and length is 135. Click on create sketch. You can select any plane. Suppose I will select this one. Pan it. Click on line. Click on this origin point. Take your cursor on this side, 75, click. Take your cursor on this side, length is 135, then press tab for angle. Now we want this angle of 45. That means angle from this line will be 180 minus 45. So you can directly type here 180 minus 45. Take your cursor above and click. So here this line is created at 135 degree angle. Right click, cancel. Zoom minus, pan. Then we want same sketch on the opposite side. So for that we will have to mirror it around this center line. So this line will be parallel to this line. That means angle of this line will be 45 degree. So type L for line. Click on this origin point, take your cursor on this side, then specify any length, suppose 200, press tab, 45, enter. Then for mirror, we need this line in center line format. So select this line, right click and click here on normal center line. Click outside, then arrange these dimensions for proper visibility. Then click here on mirror. Then select all these objects. As there was only one center line, it has selected it perfectly. Click on OK. Then I will just turn off these constraints so that drawing will be visible properly. So click here, zoom minus. Then again we will have to mirror on this side. For that we will need one center line here. Type L, click on this point, take on this side, ensure that line is straight, click, right click, cancel. Click on this line, right click, then normal center line, click outside, click on mirror, then click and hold in empty space, take your cursor on this side. Ensure that all the objects are inside this window and release first mouse button. So all the objects are selected. Then click here on select and select this center line. Click on OK. Then we will again have to mirror it around this horizontal line. Click on line. Click on this endpoint. Right click. Cancel. Click. You can also convert this line into center line by clicking here on center line. Click outside. Again click on mirror. Select this object. Then to cancel selection of this line, click on it. Then click here. Click on this line. Click on OK. Then next is these two circles of 80 diameter and 60 radius, that is 120 diameter. Click on center diameter circle. Click here on this midpoint, take your cursor away, specify diameter of 120, click, take it away, 80, click. Right click, cancel. So this object is also ready. Again click here on new design. Then next is this one. In this object, at first we will create this line of 225 length and this line of 300 length, and then we will place this dimension of 150 degree. Click on create sketch, select plane, click on line, take it to center, take it away, click, then pan it above, click, right click, cancel, click on sketch dimension, click, 225, enter, click, 300, enter, then again select this line, and click, 150, enter, then fit, zoom minus, right click, cancel. Then select this line, control this line, click here on center line, click outside. Then next is these two circles of 45 and 90 diameter. Click on center diameter circle, click on this end point, take it away, 45, click, again click, take it away, 90, click. Then this circle of 180 and 120 diameter. Click, 120, click, 180, click. Then 30 and 60 diameter. Click, 30, click, 60, enter. Then to create tangent lines, click here on line, click on this circle, then take your cursor ahead. Once tangent symbol is shown, click there. Same way here, click, tangent is shown, click, then again click, then tangent is shown, click, again click, tangent is shown, click, then right click, cancel. Now tangent is applied on only one side, so we will have to apply manual tangent here. For that, click here on tangent, select this circle, this line, this circle, this line, same way here, circle, line, circle and line, right click, cancel. So here tangents are applied perfectly. Then next is to remove these circles. For that, click here on trim, then click on unwanted objects, then zoom here. We will remove this line and this line, then right click, cancel. Then we will convert this arc into reference arc. For that, select this arc and click here on construction and click on fit. So here now this sketch is fully defined. So all these sketches are ready. So that's all for now. In the next tutorial we will learn 3D concepts. So thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. We will again meet in next tutorial.